Hi guys, my name is Mandeep and in today's video we are going to discuss about big O notation. In this video, first we will discuss about the definition part of big O notation. Then we will discuss some of the examples which will fit into the definition of big O notation. So let's get started without wasting any more time. So let us assume that g, there is a function, non-negative function gn, which takes as n as non-negative value as an input, and if we have to calculate the big O of this gn, then it will be a set of functions fn such that there exist constant c and n naught such that f of n is always less than equal to c dot c of gn for all the values of n which are greater than n naught. So this is the whole definition part of big O notation, which is quite lengthy and may become messy if we do not consider some of the examples here. So let us take an example. Let us assume that we have an algorithm A whose complexity is denoted by this function fn, which is some hypothetical case I am taking over here, is 5n square plus 2n plus 1, and the gn is the function rate of growth denotes for this function is n square. Now for this hypothetical value of how n square comes out, you can watch my previous video. In that previous video I have described how we can calculate the rate of growth from an time complexity. So gn is n square. So if we try to fit these two values inside this expression over here, then it becomes like this way: fn is my 5n square plus 2n plus 1, which is less than equal to c, and my gn is n square. So now we have to find the value of c and n. First let me tell you about this. Please do not confuse about n and n naught. N naught is nothing, n naught is n itself, but that n naught is that value of n after which or for which this statement holds true. Fine. So n naught is nothing, n naught is one of the value of n which we are going to find out from over here. So if I have to find the value of from this expression which states true, if I take n as 0 for this first iteration and try to find out, so 1, this will be 0, 0, 0 plus 1 is less than 0. This is not true. So n, it cannot be 0. And if I take n as 1 and I put the value in this, it will become 5 plus 2 plus 1 is less than equal to c, n. So from over here we can find out that c, value of c could be greater than equal to 8, and for the value of n is equal to 1. So for this value of n, this statement holds true. This statement for this value of n 1 and this value of c, this statement holds true. So if I take any value which is greater than, so from here we can conclude that this value of n is equal to 1 denotes the n 0. So if I take any value which is greater than equal to n naught, which is 1, so if I take any value which is greater than n naught, which is 1, if I take 2 in this expression, I put, then it will be 2 into n square sorry, 5 into n square, which is 4 plus 4 plus 1 is less than value of c is 8, and n square is 4. So this is 25 is less than equal to 32, which again holds true. So this is how we can find out the big O notation, and we can describe it. So if you guys find this video that much worthy that it can earn your like, subscribe and comment, please do it, and please provide me comments and feedback also. Thanks for watching.